So today let's take a look at some Nixie tubes, and finally let's make an autopsy of some. Nixie tubes are more or less some kind of a display which can display numbers from 0 to 9. They are filled with a gas, usually neon, which glows when energized, and there are 10 numbers usually inside, and the one that's connected to power will light up. As you can see, Nixie tube is basically a glass tube with neon gas in it, and there are 10 electrodes, and they are in shapes of numbers. So the one that's energized will light up and display the number. They come in various sizes and shapes. There are big ones like this one, medium ones like this one, and small ones like this one. They can be side view Nixies or a top view Nixies like this one. Some of them go into a socket like this one, and some of them are soldered directly into a board. They have wires instead of pins. Nixie tubes used to be a part of measuring and automation equipment. Here you can see some display made of Nixie tubes. Here's another, those are side view Nixies with some drivers on the board. This is a board from some multimeter or voltmeter. Here you can see the Nixies and remains of the circuitry, some chips and other parts. And there is another board from some voltmeter or multimeter or maybe a frequency counter with Nixies and other circuitry. Here you can see a vintage crystal, quite a nice crystal. Here you can see an example of a Nixie machine that's still working. It's a Nixie voltmeter with AC and DC ranges, and it still works really well. Nixies were in use from about 60s to about 80s, and they were part of industrial or laboratory equipment like voltmeters, multimeters, frequency counters, digital measurement, automation timers, stopwatches, and so. They were actually never used in consumer products. Nixie tubes require quite a high voltage for operation. The ignition voltage is 170 volts usually, and so the supply must have at least this voltage. The operation voltage or a voltage drop is usually about 140 volts. The operating current is about 1.5 to 2.5 milliamps in those small ones, about 3 to 6 milliamps in those medium ones, and 4 to 7 milliamps in this big one. So let's see some of them in operation. This is the big one. You can see the digits in it. And this is a medium-sized one. Also nice. And a small one with 2 decimal points in it. And here's a top view Nixie. There are also some Nixies with scientific symbols instead of numbers, like plus, minus, pico, micro, mega, kilo, percent, nano, and so. In a Nixie there is one common anode, and this is the mesh. The mesh can have different shapes in different Nixies. This one has square holes, and this one has hexagonal holes. And there are 10 cathodes, and those cathodes are the numbers. You always connect the anode to the positive, and then you can connect any of those cathodes to the negative, and any of those numbers will light up. But now let's start with the autopsy. The victim is going to be this ZM1040 from Tesla, made in former Czechoslovakia. This one is not working anymore, so we can take a look inside. So, you can see the anode. The anode is a metal sheet at the back and a mesh at the front. Here you can see some getter. This is probably a heat activated getter. It probably has been activated in manufacture using some induction heater. And this one looks like another kind of getter or maybe a giver. I'm not sure. Let's continue the autopsy. So you see the entire anode with all the numbers. This type is open at the top. There is no mica window or so. There are some insulators, probably some ceramic insulators to insulate those cathodes from this support. And there is some ring. It looks like some radioactive material to help igniting the arc. This is to start it faster or to make the ignition voltage lower. There are two supports. The digits are supported from two sides, from the top and from the bottom. Here you can see the base with pins, and those cathodes have some wires coming from them, and the wires are spot welded to the pins. The pins are coming through the glass here, and this ceiling must be airtight so no air goes in, because this tube is evacuated and there is just a low pressure. It's filled with neon at low pressure, so if this ceiling was leaking, the air would be sucked in and it will no longer be working. Those two go to the anode. There is an internal connection in between. And it is connected to this metal sheet. It's spot welded. So those two pins are the anode. And the other pins are the cathodes. Let's remove the base. With my snips. So the base is gone now. Here you can see the wires coming from the cathodes. And there is a mica window or mica insulator. Let's cut this one. And now I can remove the mica ring. Maybe. Yes. And I can see into the chamber. Now there are two support wires, which I'm going to remove. And does it fall apart? No, it's actually spot welded here. So I have to open it like this. And it opens from this side. And you can see the beautiful numbers, which are in some strange order. It is 102. 5, 4, 3, 4. I can't see it. Now it's falling apart already. The number 7 seems to be in the very front. And it's made of a metal sheet with steel rings for support, and this connection wire is the part of the number. It's just one piece of metal sheet. Then there is number 6. Number 8. The next one is number 5. There are some insulation sleeves on those support wires to prevent short circuit, and also some insulation rings in between of those numerals. Here you can see number 4. I'm trying to stay in the view. Number 9. Then number 4, number 3, number 2, then 0, and finally number 1. The number 1 is just one straight piece of wire. There are the insulation rings and the support wires. They used to have this kind of hollow sleeve on it for insulation, like this. And that's it. Those two wires are connected with the anode, so the numbers have to be isolated from them. And this one surely is a getter activated by an induction heater. This one may be another getter, or maybe a giver, mercury giver or so. And this one is probably some small radioactive source, some ionizing source to help faster ignition or to make the ignition voltage lower. This must be some radioactive isotope. And this is the mesh. This one is with hexagonal holes, but some of them actually are with square holes or different shapes of holes. This is the back of the anode, and it's not transparent because you don't have to see the numbers from the back. So this is more or less the entire Nixi tube. The Nixi tube has pins with some sealing. I guess there is molybdenium on those pins to make a good sealing with the glass. And at the bottom there used to be an evacuation stem, right in the middle in between of the pins. So is this one radioactive? Let's check it. Maybe just very slightly. That's disappointing. So when a Nixi tube is being made, they just take this metal plate, they spot weld a getter on it and a giver on it, then they spot weld those pins on it, they put some isolation tube on the pins. I'm trying to stay in the focus. Then they put some isolation rings on it. They put some numbers on it, like 0, 2, and of course there must be an isolation ring in between of each numbers. Let's put 9, or it's actually the other way around, but it doesn't matter now, just a very quick Stupid Nixie production, very cheap Chinese Nixie. So let's put some very distorted number 6 on it, some isolation rings on it. Real Nixies are of course made with much more effort. Let's put some other number like 4. The other way around, of course. Let's forget some isolation rings to make a short circuit in it. So it's a very shitty Nixie tube. Okay, I completely forgot the isolation rings and tubes at the top, so it's going to be completely shorted out, but it doesn't matter. It's going to be sold very cheaply. Put number 5 on it and it's more or less it. Maybe I lost some of the numbers, but it doesn't matter. Okay, number 3 is going to be missing. So now let's take some mesh. Let's put some radioactive source on it in this case. Let's spot weld it together like this. And let's take some mica window or mica insulator and shove it on it like this. And this is going to be very shitty Nixie tube. Now let's spot weld some base on it. Like this. It's just a piece of a base, but it doesn't matter, because this is a very cheap Chinese production. And finally, let's spot weld it here. And I think the production looks like this. There is just a base with the pins coming through it, and then they take some bulb, slide it on it, and weld it around the base. And we have the entire Nixie tube now. And it's almost starting to be working. Yeah, it's almost the entire Nixie tube. Then, if you have a Nixie tube, you can take the evacuation stem, evacuate it, then you can seal it. You take an induction heater, heat this one, and that's it. And you have a Nixie tube. A very shitty one, actually. So let's take a look at one more Nixie. This one is made in about 70s in East Germany by RFT. And this one is solderable. And it's a small one. And also it doesn't work. And it's a similar construction with a mesh here. And a solid anode from the other side. But there is a mica window at the top and no getter here. There is some kind of getter. And there are the wires spot welded onto it. Let's make just a very quick teardown. Remove those wires. There is some kind of a glass tube on it, and this glass tube seems to be some kind of a giver with a wire around it, and this wire probably is to heat it up. This wire is connected in between of two pins, and when a current is applied, it heats up and activates this giver or getter or whatever it is. Did it contain mercury at the beginning? Maybe it did, and the current through this wire heats it up and evaporates the mercury. There is some kind of a pill similar to the other one, even though the other one is not black. This one has a mica window on it, so let's remove it. There are some ceramic rods as a support, and this is the anode, the mesh, let's remove it. Okay. There are the numbers. It's a very similar construction. There are some isolation rings. There's some glass tube isolating the pin of the anode. And this tube is there to prevent arcing between those wires. There are the numbers with those insulators, and the wires go from the numbers and they are spot welded onto the pins. So now I can probably remove the numbers from it. I have number 6 and it's the same construction with two holes in it for support and a wire coming from it. And that's more or less it. There is not much of it inside. So this is a small Nixie from East Germany. Let's take a closer look at the getters and pails. This one is made of metal sheet and it seems to be double layer. So let's open it up. And inside there is some broken glass. So was this a mercury pail? What's this one? Looks like some kind of getter. And this one. Also probably a getter. Now it shatters. Probably a getter. So this is Diagon Wild and see you in my next videos.